It's nice to see you again. My name is Algis Mborongon and I am your teacher of English. So today we're going to see a new lesson which is entitled Active and Passive Voice. Donc je disais que je m'appelle Monsieur Mborongon Algis et je suis professeur d'anglais. Donc aujourd'hui nous allons suivre la leçon sur les voix actives et la voix passive. What do we mean by active voice? Active voice is when you have a sentence and in that sentence, the subject does the action of the verb. Donc, le sujet de la voix active fait l'action du verbe. D'où on dit que cette phrase-là est à la voix active. Le sujet est le responsable de l'action du verbe qui est dans cette phrase. Let's write a sentence is in active voice when the subject of that sentence does the action of the verb. Donc, on dit qu'une phrase est à la voix active lorsque le sujet de cette phrase-là fait l'action du verbe qui est conjugué dans la même phrase. Let's give one example. On va donner un exemple. Example. You say, I speak English. I speak English. Je parle anglais. Ici, le sujet étant I, le sujet c'est I, this is the subject, and the verb is speak. English is the object. I speak English. Je parle anglais. Ici, c'est je qui fait l'action du verbe parler. I can give another sentence, une autre phrase. She ate my cake. She ate my cake. She is the subject and it does the action of the verb to eat. Elle a mangé mon gâteau. She ate my cake. And the last sentence, we can put one with a modal verb. We can do it. We can do it. We is also the subject and it does the action of the verb to do. We are able to do it. This is the active voice. So you have a subject doing the action of the verb here as well. She does the action of the verb to eat. And it is the same case with the third sentence. Now let's move to passive voice. Passive voice. Passive voice. What do we mean by passive voice? C'est quoi la voix passive? Passive voice is when you have a sentence, but its subject is victim. Its subject undergoes the action of the verb. Donc, à la voix passive, le sujet subit l'action. Le sujet est victime de l'action du verbe. Let's write. A sentence is in passive voice. The sentence is in passive voice. Passive voice when it's subject is victim of or undergoes the action of the verb. Good. A sentence is in active, in passive voice when its subject undergoes or is victim of the action of the verb. Donc, on dit qu'une phrase est à la voix passive lorsque le sujet de cette phrase subit l'action du verbe. A sentence is in passive voice when its subject is victim of the action of the action the o and the girls. So it's victim of the action of the verb. Okay? It's victim of the action of the verb. The action of oh sorry. What have I written? The action of it's not here, sorry. Of the action of the verb. Yes, this is it. Example. Example. If we take a sentence in active voice, this one, for example, if we take I speak English, which is in active voice, I speak English. The sentence is in active voice. This is active voice. How to turn this sentence into passive voice? How to turn this sentence in passive voice? Comment transformer cette phrase-là à la voix passive? There is a condition to fulfill. Il y a une condition qu'il faut respecter. To turn a sentence from active into passive voice, there must be in that sentence an object. Il faut qu'il y ait dans cette phrase, quand on vous demande de mettre la voix passive, un complément d'objet. And how to find it? You have to do this. You look for the subject, the verb, and what is this? He says, I speak English. Je parle anglais. What do I speak? Alors en français, vous diriez, je parle anglais. Je parle quoi? Je parle anglais. So, English is our object. C'est un complément d'objet. So, this sentence can be turned from active into passive voice. How to do this operation? Comment réaliser cette opération? You have to do a kind of cross like this. Like this. Before I give the structure, you have a kind of cross. The object becomes the subject. And the subject is going to take the place of the object. We, for example, say English. This is our object. Let's say English. After the object, we conjugate the verb to be, but not at random. Après qu'on a trouvé le complément d'objet, il faut maintenant conjuguer le verbe être. Comment le conjuguer? Ça ne se fait pas au hasard. Il faut s'arranger à déterminer quel est le ton du verbe to speak ici. The verb to speak is conjugated in the present simple. Comme il est conjugué au présent simple, alors notre to be va aussi être conjugué au présent simple. So you say, English is, l'anglais est, and you come back to the verb, tu reviens au verbe et tu cherches son participe passé. Quel est le participe passé du verbe to speak? It is spoken. English is spoken. L'anglais est parlé. Is spoken by me. L'anglais est parlé par moi. Comme c'était je, alors l'objet devient moi. English is spoken by me. This is the structure for the passive voice. Voici la structure de la voix passive. As you can see, in active voice, you have the subject, the verb, and the object. But in passive voice, the subject becomes the object, and the object becomes the subject. So the structure is this one, object, l'objet, on commence par l'objet, plus the verb to be, plus le verbe être, qu'on ne conjugue pas au hasard. Il faut tenir compte du temps du verbe qui est à la voix active. You have to take into account the tense of the verb in active voice. So you have to be. After the verb to be, you come back to the verb here. You look for its past participle, le participe passé du verbe qui est dans la phrase active. You say past participle. Past participle. Plus, by, qui veut dire par. So you have object, the verb to be, past participle of the verb in active voice, plus the subject that was here, the subject. I put between bracket of the subject of active voice. Et donc, on répète, on prend le sujet de la voix active qui devient maintenant le complément à la voix passive. This is the structure. The structure is this one. Example, one more example. Example. You can say, Hemingway wrote, good novels. Hemingway wrote good novels. Hemingway a écrit de bons romans. Hemingway wrote good novels. So, to turn into passive voice, as I said, you have to do this. The first thing to look for is, where is the subject in our sentence? Où est le sujet dans cette phrase? The subject is Hemingway. This is the subject. And after the subject, you look for the verb. You have always to do this. You must always. Il faut toujours procéder comme ceci. Tu cherches le sujet. Où est-il? Le sujet est là. Le verbe, où est-il? Il est là. Et ceci, est-ce que c'est un complément d'objet? Voilà la question que vous devez vous poser. Est-ce que c'est un complément d'objet? Si ça ne l'est pas, alors on ne peut pas mettre la voix passive. And we put the question, Hemingway wrote good novels. Hemingway écrivait de bons romans. Hemingway écrivait quoi? De bons romans. So this one is an object. As it is an object, comme c'est un complément d'objet, alors on peut mettre cette phrase à la voix passive. So we say, good novels. And you come back to the verb here, because after the object, which is good novel, you have to conjugate the verb to be. Il faut maintenant conjuguer le verbe to be. Et comme j'ai dit, ça ne se conjugue pas au hasard. You have to take into account. Il faut prendre en compte le temps du verbe qui est à la voix active ici. What is the tense of this verb? Wrote. Quel est le temps de ce verbe-là? It is in the preterite or the past simple. Comme le verbe de la voix active est au prétérite, au passé simple, il nous faudra donc conjuguer to be aussi au passé. What are we going to say? The subject is good novels. De bons romans. Il n'y a pas un seul roman, on dit de bons romans, il y en a beaucoup. So, we have the choice. Either it is was or it is were. Since we have many novels, so we say good novels were good novels, de bons romans were, étaient, and you look for the past participle of the verb wrote here. The verb to write. Its past participle is written. Is written. Good novels were written by Hemingway. Were written by there's no more space, let's come here, were written by Hemingway. By Hemingway. Good. Le bon roman était écrit par Hemingway. Another example. He received the Nobel Prize. He received the Nobel Prize in 1954. Il a reçu le prix Nobel de la littérature. The Nobel Prize, le prix Nobel. Il a reçu quoi? What did he receive? Il a reçu le prix Nobel. Il is our subject. He received the Nobel Prize. Received is the verb. Received, c'est le verbe. And the Nobel Prize is the object. At the time, we can turn it from active into passive voice. What are we going to say? It's going to be the Nobel Prize. This is the object, the Nobel Prize. And we come back to the verb. The verb to receive is conjugated in the preterite as well. So we have the choice between was and were, because we must conjugate after the object, we need to come back to the verb to be. Since the active sentence is in the past, so we must use was or were, since Nobel Prize is singular, so we say the Nobel Prize was, le prix Nobel, the Nobel Prize was, était, and this one is a regular verb, so you don't need to fight for nothing. You have the past participle here. The Nobel Prize was received. Was received by, when it is he as subject, the object is him. Was received by him. Was received by him. Let's take a sentence with the verb in the present simple this time. We love African music. They say the sentence almost all of you know. We love African music. Nous aimons la musique africaine. We love African music. The first step. Where is the subject? Where is the verb? And where is the object? Our subject here is we. Nous aimons la musique africaine. We love. Love is the verb, and African music is the object. Nous aimons la musique africaine. The verb to love is conjugated in the present simple. And as we know, when it is in the present simple, the verb to be has also to be in the present simple. So we start with our object. You say, African music, la musique africaine, African music, when you have a verb in the present simple in active voice, the choice is this one. Lorsque le verbe de la phrase qui est à la voix active et qu'on vous demande de mettre à la voix passive est au présent simple, vous devez conjuguer, bien entendu, le verbe être. Le choix est ici. Il faut maintenant regarder l'objet. Est-ce que l'objet est au singulier? À ce moment, c'est is. Est-ce que l'objet c'est I, à ce moment c'est am. Est-ce que l'objet est au pluriel we, you, they, à ce moment c'est are. African music is one, la musique africaine. So we say African music is. And after the verb to be, we come back to the structure here and we take the past participle of the verb to love, which is simply loved, because to love is a regular verb. African music is loved by, when it is we, the object becomes us. African music is loved by us. Okay? Now, here we have seen the present simple and the past. So I repeat again, when the sentence in active voice is in the present, the verb to be must be in the present simple as well. Sorry, there's a mistake here. By. I miswrote by. Okay. I repeat. When the verb in the active voice is in the past simple, the verb to be is either was or were, depending on the subject. Si le sujet au pluriel, le sujet, le verbe to be, c'est was. Si le verbe de la voix active était au passé. S'il est au pluriel, je veux dire, le verbe to be, c'est were. Et s'il est au singulier, le verbe to be, c'est was. Là, c'est si le verbe de la voix active était au passé. Et s'il est au présent simple, l'auxiliaire être, c'est soit am, dépendant du sujet. Si c'est I am. Si c'est he, she, it, donc is. Et donc, si c'est we, you, they, c'est are. Let's move to sentences with perfect tenses. Perfect tenses. Let's just write perfect tenses. It has to be big for you to see. Perfect tenses. How to turn a sentence from active into passive voice when the verb is in the perfect tense, such as the present perfect, the past perfect, okay? How to do it? Here we have just the verb to be, let's just say, in perfect tenses, comma, to be is either, is either, or dans les temps composés, donc les perfect tenses, to be est soit, have, ou, has been, have ou has been, là c'est lorsque c'est au present perfect, à la voix active, or it is had been, it is had been. When you have a sentence in active voice, which is in the present perfect, the past perfect, you have to conjugate the verb to be after the object. So you have to use either had been for the past perfect, have been or has been for the present perfect. Example, we can say they have won the cup. They have won the cup. They have won the cup. Ils ont gagné la coupe. They have won the cup. The sentence is in the present perfect. Cette phrase, dans cette phrase-là, le verbe est conjugué au present perfect. Et cette phrase est à la voix active. This is active voice. How to turn the sentence from active into passive voice? The first step is always to look for The subject, where is the subject? Is they. The verb is have. This is the verb. And the cup is our object. When you have done this, the work becomes easier. You have already done the most important part. Tu connais déjà les éléments de la phrase, le sujet, le verbe et le complément d'objet. So you have just to reverse. Il faut juste faire une sorte de quoi. Donc, tu commences par la dernière partie. You say the cup. The cup. La coupe. The cup. And you come back to the verb. What tense is it conjugated in? It is conjugated in the present perfect. The present perfect. Comme le verbe de la voix active est conjugué au present perfect, nous allons donc conjuguer le verbe to be aussi au present perfect. Et comment conjuguer le verbe to be au present perfect? You have either, c'est soit have been, ou alors has been, il faut maintenant tenir compte du sujet. Le sujet étant the cup, et comme il est au singulier, we're going to say the cup has been won is also the past participle. The cup has been won. La coupe a été gagnée by them. Good. The cup has been won by them. Let's come back to the first part of our board. I guess you're finished. And let's take another example. In the past perfect this time. Another example. You had cooked chicken. Vous aviez préparé du poulet. You had cooked chicken. You is our subject. Had cooked is the verb and chicken is the object. So, in passive voice, we have chicken, which is our object. Since this verb, cooked, is conjugated in the past perfect, so we say chicken had, as we said it here, chicken had been, and you take the past participle, had been cooked by you. Chicken had been cooked by you. Now, let's move to progressive tenses. Progressive tenses. When you have progressive tenses, progressive tenses. What do I mean by progressive tenses? What do I mean by progressive tenses? Progressive tenses, ce sont des temps continus comme le présent continu, le passé continu, le futur continu, ainsi de suite. OK? Present continuous. Good. Progressive tenses. When the verb in active voice is in a progressive tense or continuous tense, before you put the past participle. Alors, lorsque la phrase qu'on vous demande de mettre la voix active à un verbe qui est conjugué à un temps continu, comme le présent continu, Vous avez donc votre objet, vous prenez l'objet, vous conjuguez le verbe to be en tenant compte du temps. Maintenant, avant de mettre le participe passé, vous devez d'abord ajouter ceci. In the progressive tenses, we need being just after to be and before the past participle. Before the past participle. What do I mean? If you consider the structure, we said you have the object in passive voice, of course. The object of the active voice becomes the subject. After that object, you need the verb to be. And after the verb to be, you need the past participle. This is when the tense is a normal one. But when you have progressive tenses, such as the verb, the present continuous, the present perfect continuous, you must use being after you've used your object and to be, before you use the past participle. Donc, lorsque c'est un temps continu, comme le présent continu, le passé continu, vous devez, après avoir retrouvé votre objet, donc après avoir commencé votre phrase par l'objet, après avoir conjugué le verbe être, avant d'aller au participe passé, vous devez mettre cette expression « being » si le temps est un temps continu. Et ensuite, vous mettez le participe passé. Example. Let's take our example. You have example. Let's say the prime minister is making a speech now. The prime minister is making a speech now. Le premier ministre est en train de faire un discours maintenant, en ce moment, il est en train de faire un discours. How to turn this sentence into passive voice. Comment mettre cette phrase à la voix passive? Always proceed as I am doing. The prime minister is your subject. Il faut toujours commencer par là, identifier les éléments de votre phrase, où est le sujet, où est le verbe et où est le complément. The prime minister is making, this is our verb, a speech. The prime minister is making a speech. And we have a problem. We have now. Now. What is now? Is now part of the object? No, it's not. En français, on dit le premier ministre est en train de faire un discours maintenant. Alors, est-ce que maintenant fait partie du complément d'objet? Non. Pourquoi? Parce que la question, ce serait donc, le premier ministre est en train de faire quoi maintenant? Le premier ministre est en train de faire quoi? Il est en train de faire un discours. À quel moment? Maintenant. Ici, maintenant, c'est un complément circonstanciel de temps. It is a complement of time. Alors vous le laissez là où il est, vous n'y touchez pas, vous procédez comme on a fait avant. Donc vous commencez par l'objet, celui-là vous faites comme s'il n'existait pas, vous le laissez là où il était là-bas. So you say, you start by a speech, and you come back to the verb. What tense do we have here? We have is and a verb to which we've added ing, which means this is the present continuous. Comme c'est le présent continu, et donc notre auxiliaire étant is, notre to be est donc là, c'est simplement le présent. Vous savez, a speech is, comme c'est un temps continu, après qu'on a conjugué le verbe être, qui fait partie de la structure, de la formule, alors il faut revenir à ce que nous avons dit ici. When you have a progressive tense in active voice, you must use being just after the verb to be. Et donc, on doit mettre being ici. You see? A speech is being, ce qui revient à dire en français, un discours est en train d'être, is being, and you come back to the verb to which we've added ing, le verbe auquel on a ajouté ing. Quel est son participe passé? The past participle for this verb is known of everyone. Il est connu de tous, même si c'est de façon inconsciente. Vous dites made in China. Made, c'est son participe passé. C'est le participe passé du verbe to make. Donc, on le met ici. Is made. OK? A speech is being made. Un discours est en train d'être fait. A speech is being made by the prime minister. By the prime minister. You see? If it were not a progressive tense, si ce n'était pas un temps continu, on n'aurait pas eu besoin de being. Mais comme notre phrase est au présent continu, il faut obligatoirement la présence de being. Another example, you say, She has been reading. Et vous remettez votre noun juste là où il était. Voilà. She has been reading. Books. She has been reading books. Elle lit ses livres. Elle est en train de lire ses livres. C'est le present perfect continuous. It is continuous because you have ing and you have the verb to be here. She has been reading books. Where is the subject? The subject is she. C'est notre sujet. Je répète qu'il faut toujours procéder comme cela pour ne pas vous embrouiller. Vous trouvez le sujet. The verb is this one. She has been reading. And you have her books, which is our object. The object is going now to be the subject of the passive voice. You say her books. Books, ses livres. Since we have the present perfect continuous, you consider this rule. So you say her books. You have many books. They are numerous. So you use have. Her books. Have. Her books have. Her books have been. Books have been. At the time, we have used our object. On a utilisé notre complément d'objet. Et on a conjugué le verbe être. Comme c'est un temps continu, since it is a progressive tense, we need to use being. Books have been being, okay, have been being, and we use the past participle of the verb to read, have been being read by her. Ces livres étaient ou sont en train d'être lus par elle, simplement. Now, let's move to modal verbs. Yes, passive voice with modal verbs. Modal verbs. Passive voice with modal verbs. What do we do when the sentence in active voice is has a modal verb inside and we are asked to put it into passive voice? Lorsque la phrase qu'on nous demande de mettre à la voix passive a en son sein un verbe de modalité comme can, may, must, should, and so on, qu'est-ce qu'on fait? We need when we have a modal verb. When we have a modal verb in active voice, comma, we just use that. Just use that modal verb plus B and we add the past participle, and we use the past participle. Allez, ok. Lorsque la phrase qui est à la voix active et qu'on nous demande de mettre à la voix passive a un complément, je veux dire a un verbe de modalité comme can, may, pour mettre cette phrase à la voix passive, on ne va plus dire is, are, non. On utilise le même verbe de modalité si c'est can, si c'est may, et puis on ajoute be. Example, on met toujours une phrase à la voix active pour bien vous aider. You say, we can beat them. We can beat them. Nous pouvons les battre. We can beat them. We is our subject. And we have a modal verb here. Un verbe de modalité qui est can. Verbe pouvoir. We can beat them. Nous pouvons les battre. Comme nous avons un verbe de modalité, ceci fait partie donc du verbe. This is the verb. And we have our object. We start our passive voice by when it is, since it is them. Them est un pronom personnel complément. Donc, il ne peut pas conjuguer un verbe. Il ne peut pas être au début d'une phrase. So, we replace them by its personal pronoun subject. Since this one is a personal pronoun object, on doit maintenant trouver le pronom personnel sujet qui correspond à them. Et donc, dans le cas d'espèce, c'est they. They, ok? Alors, comme on a un verbe de modalité, on sait que selon la structure, il faut maintenant conjuguer le verbe to be. Comme on a can, on le prend. You use can be. You say can be as we said it here. You take the modal verb. On a pris le verbe modal and we've added be. Ici, on a conjugué le verbe to be. Okay? So, They can be, and you look for the past participle of the verb to beat. Quel est le participe passé du verbe to beat? C'est, voilà, beaten. They can be beaten by us. Ils peuvent être battus par nous. Nous pouvons les battre. Ils peuvent être battus par nous. Let's take another example. Another example. In negative form, for example, you say, you must not buy this house. You must not buy this house. You must not buy this house. Vous ne devez pas acheter cette maison. You must not buy this house. Alors, si la phrase est au présent, le verbe to be au présent, on l'a dit, si la phrase est à la forme négative, à la voix active, la phrase passive doit aussi être à la forme négative. How to turn this one into passive voice? Our object is this one. Voici notre objet, notre complément d'objet. And you have the verb here. This one is the subject. Since we have found our elements, so we do the operation. You say, this house, this is the object, this house. We have must, which is a modal verb. Comme c'est un verbe modal, on revient ici. On utilise ce verbe modal plus be pour conjuguer le verbe to be selon la structure. This house must. Et vous regardez la forme de la phrase. Since this sentence in active voice is in negative form, so in passive voice, we must also use the negative form. This house must not be, this house must not be, cette maison ne doit pas être, must not be bought by you. Cette maison ne doit pas être achetée par vous ou par toi. You must not buy this house. Bought is the past participle of the verb to buy. Okay? Let's move to our next step. Passive voice with questions. How to put a question, which is an active voice, into passive voice? How to do this? Let's say, questions. Questions. How to turn a question, which is an active voice, into a passive voice? You have to take into account, two aspects into account. What kind of question, what type of question do you have? If it is, one, a yes or no question, yes or no question, we proceed differently. If you have yes or no questions, we proceed differently. Si la question qu'on te demande de transformer à la voix passive est une question, et yes or no question, donc une question à laquelle on répond par oui ou par non, celle qui commence par un auxiliaire, la procédure est celle-ci. You need... we just do this. We just do this. The structure, just the structure. You need to use the auxiliary to be. You have to be plus the object. To be plus the object plus the past participle plus the past
the past, participle,
plus the past participle,
plus by as usual, plus by, plus the subject of active voice, plus the subject and question mark. This is what you have to keep in your mind.
It's this. When you have a yes or no question, such as this one, do you speak English? Do you speak English? This is a yes or no question because it starts in an auxiliary. C'est une yes or no question. Donc, une question à laquelle on répond soit par oui ou par non parce que ça commence par un auxiliaire. Alors, comment transformer cette question qui est à la voix active à la voix passive? Comment faire cette opération? You have, do you speak English? Alors, tu commences par le verbe to be. Mais pour arriver au verbe to be, il faut d'abord faire comme nous avons fait avant. You look for the subject. Où est le sujet dans cette phrase? The subject is you. Where is the verb? The verb is speak. And English is the object. Do is our auxiliary. This is the auxiliary. Since it is do, comme c'est do, ça veut dire que la phrase, la question est au présent simple. Since the question is in present simple, this means the verb to be is also going to be conjugated in the present simple. Le verbe to be va donc aussi être conjugué au présent simple parce que nous avons do ici. Alors, l'objet étant English, English is one, so the verb to be is going to be just is. After the verb to be, we take the object we have here. Is English. Is English. Is English. After the object, you take or you look for the past participle of the verb. D'où on vous dit que le verbe est très important. C'est la base même dans l'apprentissage de la langue anglaise et de toutes les langues d'ailleurs. Il faut donc apprendre les verbes par cœur. Si tu ne connais pas le participe passé du verbe, tu ne peux pas faire cet exercice. English is spoken. This is the past participle of the verb. Is English spoken? L'anglais is English spoken. Alors, la langue anglaise est-elle parlée? La langue anglaise est-elle parlée? By, our subject is you, so you does not change. Is English spoken by you? L'anglais est-elle, la langue bien entendu, est-elle parlée par vous, par toi? Let's take another sentence. Did you? Let's just change. Did they call? Did they call Anna yesterday? Did they call Anna yesterday? Did they call Anna yesterday? Ont-ils appelé Anna hier? Avaient-ils appelé Anna hier? You do the same thing. That's looking for the subject, which is they. Okay. Did they call is the verb. Anna is the object. And we have yesterday, which is not an object. This is a complement of time. Comme ce n'est pas un complément d'objet, je l'ai déjà dit, vous le laissez là où il est pour ne pas vous causer de problème. Vous n'y touchez pas, donc vous faites votre opération à partir de cette partie-là pour que, à la fin, vous remettiez le yesterday là où il était. Alors, the object being Anna, the subject they, you have the verb call, but our auxiliary is did you. What tense do we have here? Did is the past simple or the preterite. So we need to conjugate the verb to be. On a donc besoin, comme l'auxiliaire did, c'est la marque du passé simple, ça veut dire que nous devons conjuguer le verbe être au passé simple aussi. So we say, let's say, the object being Anna, we're going to use was, puisque Anna c'est une seule personne, donc c'est was. Si c'était deux ou plusieurs personnes, on aurait dit were. Was. Anna, was Anna, Anna était-elle, was Anna, and you come to the verb to call. What is its past participle? It's simple. This one is a regular verb, so you just add ed. Comme c'est un verbe régulier, son participe passé consiste juste à lui ajouter ed, sachant qu'il se termine par l. Was Anna called? Was Anna called by? They is going to become them. Was Anna called by them? Anna était-elle appelée par eux? Was Anna called by them? Let's come back here. We can find or provide another example with a perfect tense this time. Proposons un exemple avec un temps composé cette fois-ci, which can be, for example, Have you seen John? Have you seen John? Now, this is a question. Our auxiliary is have. This is the auxiliary. And you is the subject. Seen is our verb. And John, the object. Comme c'est le present perfect, we must conjugate the verb to be in the present perfect as well. Since our object, which is going to become the subject, is one person, so we say, as, you take the object, as John, been seen by you. Okay, so for the time being, we stop here and we're going to continue next time. Wait, let's stop here for the time being, but before we separate, we leave each other, we're going to have a small applied exercise and we're going to continue our class next time. So you have applied exercise. It's simple. Turn the following sentences into passive voice. Transformez ces phrases qui sont à la voix active à la voix passive. The first sentence is answers. The first sentence is everybody drinks water. Everybody drinks water. Tout le monde boit l'eau ou boit de l'eau. This is a sentence in active voice. Now, let's do it together. On va faire ceci ensemble. Où est le sujet dans cette phrase? The subject in this sentence is everybody. This is the sentence, the subject Yes.
The verb is drinks. This is the verb. And the last part of our sentence is the object. Alors, c'est un complément. Comme nous avons un complément d'objet, donc on peut transformer cette phrase de la voix active à la voix passive. How to do it? You make a kind of cross. Vous faites une sorte de croix. Donc, les pieds deviennent la tête et la tête prend la place des pieds. Les pieds ici étant water. You say water, l'eau, water. After the object, you come to the verb here. The verb is conjugated in the present simple. Comme il est conjugué au présent simple, ça veut dire que nous devons conjuguer le verbe être au présent simple aussi. Water is singular. You replace water by it. Comme c'est une chose, so the verb to be in the present simple is. Water is. We come back to the verb again to look for its past participle. The past participle for the verb to drink is drunk. Is drunk. Water is drunk. L'eau est bu. Water is drunk. By. L'eau est bu. By. Every. By everybody. L'eau est bu par tout le monde. Okay, you may even stop just by saying, l'eau, water is drunk. Everybody drinks water. Okay, tout le monde boit l'eau. L'eau est bu par tout le monde. The second sentence is, the teacher sent me out. So, I have done the first sentence. Water is drunk by everybody. J'ai fait la première phrase. Recopiez l'exercice. Et faites la suite à la maison. Do it at home together with your friends. And see you next time. Prenez soin de vous, car le Congo a besoin de vous. Bye.